reduced broil. There we go. Well, I'll go do that. This dough's still cold. By no means an expert pizza dough shaver. That's how I do it. That is really relaxed. You can just sauce it and shape it in a paella pan. Doing it here gives me a little more time. And I'm going over here. This is just simple sauce. And tomatoes with romano, a little bit of basil blended. That's pretty much it. Because when I do it this way, it's sort of a par-bake. I'll put more sauce on than I would if I was baking the pizza all at once, because it's going to dry out. Plus, nobody minds extra sauce. Now it's going to get crazy. The oven was on with the paella pan. As high as it would go at 550. And now it's been on a broiler. And I pretty much want it to smoke, which it's almost doing. There it goes. The hotter it is, the better. Look at here. Broiler is still on. Turn my flame on high. Keep the heat there. Don't touch it. It's smoking already. That's good. To give it a little jewel. Make sure that it's still kind of loose. As quick as you can. Back in on the broiler. This is a Lodge stainless steel or carbon steel coated paella pan. I think they only make one. I started using it because it's a movable steel. You don't have to mess with stones that take forever to preheat, or because they got like little dome-shaped things that fit on the top that do the same thing. This basically is a paella pan all the way at the top of the broiler, just kind of concentrates the heat. Plus, it's a pan, and you can move it around on like a big steel, and you can put it on a range and keep bottom heat on it while you're doing anything else. And this is like the closest I've been able to come to like that fast bake. It really only needs like a couple of minutes in here. And what I'll do when I take this out, I try to remember which way I had it facing so that when I put it back in, I put it down, rotated 180 degrees. just wanna, hi George, you wanna make pizza? Yeah. Maybe meat pizza. And you just want it to get starting to crisp on the edges. Well, that's doing that. Let me get rid of this extra flour. Toppings ready to go. Use any cheese you want. I've got some cut up provolone and low moisture mozzarella and Romano and some Kalamatas and some thinly sliced onion and some Mama Lil's peppers and some very thinly sliced hard salami. And that's gotta be it. Oh yeah, there we go. This is what you're looking for. It just starts to crust. Well, turn the burner back on. By time. Get a little bit of the hard cheese first. I don't care if it goes over there, because that just makes crispy cheese on the outside. Gotta work fast because you still got the flame on the bottom. So you can obviously turn it off if you want. And judging from the smell, I'm gonna. I probably don't need to quite yet. I'm sure I'm just smelling that cheese. There you go. Pretty much. That's it. That's the tip of the pizza. It happens very quickly. Let's see. Almost there. Turn it around that way for a sec. Not as fast as like the four minutes in a wood oven, but how long is this video, Bonnie?
9 minutes, 5 seconds.
There you go. And that's from forming the dough. That's done. Even a little overdone. Because I'm talking. And the beauty of the paella pan. Okay, still loose. You bring it over here. And it comes right now. And then take one more hard cheese, some Romano. Crispy.
Gooey. Cheesy.
color of the crust. It's like this that perfect foldable. I'm not going to eat it because that's lava still. And I'll put this on a wire rack normally, but that's it. Paella pan carbon steel skillet pizza. Bye.